We want to study the median problem in communication complexity. In this problem, the input for Alice is a subset of even numbers between 1 and 2n, and the input for Bob is a subset of odd numbers between 1 and 2n. So, for example, Alice might get the set 2, 8, and 12, and Bob might get the set 3, 15, 21, and 37. Their goal is to compute the median of the union of the two sets. So in this example, the union of the two sets would be 2, 3, 8, 12, 15, 21, and 37. And the median element is the element that has the property that as many elements are smaller as there are that are larger. So this would be 12 because there are 3 smaller items and 3 larger ones in the set. Of course, we can use our trivial solution again to come up with a communication protocol for this. Alice could just transmit her entire set to Bob, and then Bob could compute the median and return the result to Alice. How many bits would this require? Well, to communicate her set to Bob, Alice would need to send n bits. This is because to encode the set, she would just indicate for each even number between 1 and 2n whether it's contained in the set or not. There are n even numbers between 1 and 2n, and so she would need n bits for this. So for example, she would say 2 is in the set, so that's a 1, and then 4 is not in her set, that's a 0, and then 6 is not in her set, that's a 0, but 8 is in the set, so that's a 1, and so on. So she communicates n bits to Bob. And then Bob computes the median element and transmit the results back to Alice. There are 2n numbers that could potentially be the median, and to encode a number between 1 and 2n, we need log 2n many bits. So Bob needs to transmit back to Alice at most log 2n bits. So in total, we have a communication protocol here that takes n plus log of 2n many bits. The main question is whether it's possible to do better than that. And the answer is that yes, we can do quite a bit better than that. And the idea is that Alice and Bob both maintain an interval for which they can be sure that the median element is within that interval. And in the beginning, they don't know much, so they start with an interval that contains all the numbers between 1 and 2n. But over time, as we run the protocol, they will narrow this range more and more, and they will restrict this interval to an interval between the numbers I and j. The hope is that in every step, in every round of this protocol that we are designing, we will be able to halve this interval, roughly. And so we know that after log n many rounds, the size of this interval will be so small that it just contains a single element. And then Alice and Bob will know for sure that that element has to be the median element. So suppose we have some interval, and Alice and Bob know this, which goes from I to j, and Alice and Bob know that the median lies within that interval for sure. Then how could they go about trying to halve, roughly, that interval? What Alice can do, she can split the interval in the middle. So she picks the midpoint, which is I plus j divided by 2, and then she checks how many of the numbers in her input from her set X lie in that first half of the interval, and how many of her numbers fall into the other half of the interval, so the part from k plus 1 to j. Let's denote the first number as Lx and the second number as Rx for left and right. And now Bob can do the same thing. He can simply check how many of his numbers fall into the first half of the interval, let's call that Ly, and how many of his numbers fall into the second part of the interval, let's call that Ry. Now, Alice and Bob can exchange this information. So Alice will send her counts, Lx and Rx, to Bob, and Bob will send his counts, Ly and Ry, to Alice. This information is sufficient for Alice and Bob to determine whether the median element lies in the first half of the interval or the second half of the interval. And so both of them can update the interval accordingly. Either they will continue with the interval I to the midpoint K, or they will continue with the interval from K to J. To see that Alice and Bob can indeed determine whether the median is in the first half of the interval or the second half of the interval just based on the information that Alice and Bob just exchanged and all the past information that Alice and Bob received, let's look at our specific example. Suppose n is equal to 20, so 2n is equal to 40, and so we start out with an interval between 1 and 40. And Alice has the numbers 2, 8, and 12. And we realize that all of those numbers are less than the midpoint of this large interval from 1 to 40, which is 20. All of those numbers lie in the first half of that interval. For Bob, Bob has the numbers 3, 15, 21, and 37. And two of those numbers lie in the first half of this interval, 3 and 15, but two of those numbers, 21 and 37, lie in the second half of the interval. Now, Bob and Alice exchanged this information, and so both of them now know that there are five numbers, three from Alice and two from Bob, that lie in the first half of the interval, and only two numbers that lie in the second half of the interval. And therefore, both of them can conclude that the answer, the median element of the set X union Y, has to be in the first half of the interval. And so they restrict the interval now to be from 1 to 20 and continue this procedure with the remaining interval. Both of them remember that two items were larger than 20, and now they just split this interval from 1 to 20 again into two halves, so the numbers from 1 to 10 and the numbers from 11 to 20. And Alice checks how many of her numbers fall into the first part of this interval, and it's the numbers 2 and 8, so two of them, whereas 12 is larger than 10, so that falls into the second half of this new interval. She tells this to Bob, and Bob does a similar thing. He determines that 3 is in the first half, 15 is in the second half. So he tells Alice that he has one number in the first half and one number in the second half. So together they conclude that the first part of the interval, the numbers from 1 to 10, the union of their two sets, X and Y, will have three numbers in that first part. And they also conclude that there will be two numbers in the second part. And they remember from the last round that there are another two numbers that are even larger than 20. So they know now that there must be, in total, four numbers bigger than 10, and there are three numbers smaller than 10. And therefore, the median element has to be larger than 10, it has to be in the second part of the interval. So both of them now know that they can restrict the interval that contains the median element for sure to be the numbers 11 to 20. And now they need to do another round to half the size of that interval and so on, and they continue doing this until only a single element, the element 12, is left. because we roughly halve the size of the candidate interval in each round, we can have at most in the order of log n many such rounds. The question is, how many bits are communicated in each round? Alice needs to tell Bob about two numbers, LX and RX, and Bob needs to tell Alice about two numbers, LY and RY. And those numbers lie in the range of, well, it could be 0 or it could be up to n. So we have four numbers that need to be communicated, which lie between 0 and n. And so we can encode those numbers using roughly log n bits. We have four of them, so it's like roughly 4 times log n many bits communicated in each round. We have log many rounds, order of log many rounds. And so the overall cost of this protocol is log n, order of log n times 4 times log n, which is in the order of log square n. We see that this is much better than the naive solution where Alice just sends her entire input to Bob and Bob does the entire computation. We said that requires n plus log 2n many bits. Now we only needed log square n many bits, which is exponentially better. You can also see that the solution isn't completely obvious. So it really pays off sometimes to sit down and think a little bit and try to come up with a better protocol than just the first thing that comes to mind, which might be very naive.